turn it up, cause it's getting heavy. Wild, wild, West Coast. These are the girls I love the most. I mean the ones, I mean like she's the one. Kiss her, touch her, squeeze her buns. The girl's afraid she drive a Jeep and live on the beach. I'm okay, I won't play, I love the bay. Just like I love LA, Venice Beach and Palm Springs. Summertime's everyday, homeboys hanging out. All that ass hanging out. Bikinis, bikinis, martinis, no weenies. Just the king and the queenie, Katie my lady. Look at here baby, I'm all up on you, cause you represent California.
Show you how to make a berry protein shake today. It's very refreshing in the summer heat and it's very easy to make. All you need is some fresh berries or frozen berries, milk of your choice. I prefer almond milk, protein powder, and some ice, and a blender, of course. The great thing about this protein shake is that the berries have a very low glycemic index. That means they're very low in fructose compared to other fruits, so you're not getting very high carbohydrate content in the shake. Berries also contain a lot of nutrients, including phytochemicals, flavonoids, vitamin C, folate, and lutein. The nutrients in the berries help prevent cancer, boost the immune system, and they also promote good vision. So now I'm going to add in the almond milk and the ice, about half a cup of ice, and depending on what consistency you want the shake, you can do half a cup if you want a thicker consistency, or you can do a full cup if you want it to be a little thinner. So I'm going to put that in, and then a scoop of whey protein powder. I don't recommend the soy protein powder because it has estrogen. We're gonna mix it. All right, and it's ready to drink. Tasty. So all you need is strawberries, blueberries, raspberries, blackberries, almond milk, or other milk if you prefer. Ice and protein powder, and you've got a great shake that'll cool you down on a hot summer day.
Hey guys, welcome to the medical segment of my video of the month. I'm going to be talking about how to properly hydrate yourself during the summer heat, and I'm also going to be talking about hyponatremia. What is hyponatremia? For those of you who don't know, hyponatremia is a condition known as sodium deficiency. It's caused by an electrolyte imbalance. When you exert yourself, you not only lose water, you lose salts as well. The combination of water loss and salt deficiency results in a condition known as vomeric hyponatremia, as well as dehydration. Sodium is an extracellular electrolyte. Its absence results in the movement of water into the cell, which causes the cells to swell in severe cases of hyponatremia. Symptoms of the condition include nausea, vomiting, headache, lightheadedness, disorientation, fatigue, muscle weakness, muscle spasms, convulsions in severe cases. The best way to prevent hyponatremia as well as dehydration in the summer heat is to rehydrate not only with water but also a drink containing electrolytes. I highly recommend coconut water or Gatorade. Other options that you could do to replenish your electrolytes are the Cliff Shot Blocks and also the goos or the gels that they sell at the local running stores, as well as sports shelters. Those all contain electrolytes, and you can take those with water so you rehydrate yourself. So remember, guys, especially all my runners and endurance athletes out there, you gotta not only replenish your water, but also your electrolytes. Thanks, guys. See you next time.